Let me share some
Go.
insights on Gayatri mantra today. The word Gayatri is a combination of two words. Gay means voice. Tri means three, three number. These three are Bhur, Bhuvah, Swaha, the earth, the heaven, and the sky. They all meet at the center of your consciousness. The other meaning of the word Gayatri is the Hiranyagarbha, otherwise called as the Hara. The very sound, the syllables, the uchharan, the way we pronounce, has to be done from the hara. It is not a lip movement or a tongue movement or a simple mental movement. It is not just a recitation. It is not just a rite and a ritual. It is not a prayer even. The purpose of chanting this mantra is to internalize your consciousness fundamentally, to make you withdraw from the mundane vibrations. At the time of the Indian baptism, otherwise called as Upanayana, Upanayana means initiation. On the way to opening the Nayana is called Upanayana. Nayana means eye. It is nowhere related to the physical eye. Nayana means to see things as they are. Upanayana means on the way to see things as they are. The beginning of the sadhana, the beginning of the practice at a particular age in India, both for boys and girls, all castes and creeds. When the Sanatana Dharma was percolating into every mind of human beings, then. Now Gayatri Mantra has been constructed as only a prayer, as only a formality to do something good. At the time of Upanayana, the Gayatri Mantra is uttered into the ear of the initiate. And he has to chant, recite that mantra from the hara. Three times a day at least. Three sandhya. Morning, afternoon and evening. When you keep on chanting, you acquire the dharana. The dharana shakti turns into dhyana. Without dharana, dhyana cannot come. The intensity has to happen in the centered consciousness. Intensity is everything. The tivarata is everything. The tapana is everything. That fire, that ambitiousness is everything. That converges you, that internalizes you, that centers you, that grounds you inside. Once sufficient level of dharana is acquired, the meditation happens. The prana flows freely. With the centered prajna, the prana flows freely. From upanayana to nayana is the journey of spirituality, the journey within. The initiate slowly utters Gayatri mantra on the hara and becomes that. What is that? That is everything. In the Sanatana Dharma period, sun was treated as a god. Sun was treated as everything. From sun we came and to sun we return, says the Surya Upanishad. The logo of Sri Rama, who was belonged to Ikshvaku dynasty, was sun. Surya, the word Ra of Surya, and Ra in Hara is same. The sun within is the Hara. The Ra, God Ra in Egyptian mythology. The Bhaskara, Surya, the Ra in Bhaskara, Ra in Surya is all same. Even in Mayans, they honored the god Ra. Sun is the deity for them. On the top of every pyramid is a sun, sun god. They used to worship sun as god. In Mayan civilization, sun was the god. There was no other deity. On the top of the pyramid was placed the sun, who was respected, honored. To see that, the sun within gets awakened. It was only symbolism. Sun within, the Surya Yoga is everything. Awakening of the sun within is everything. There is a real practice. Awakening of the sun within begins with the chanting of Gayatri Mantra. Bhur, Bhuvah, Swaha, the three dimensions, the earth, heaven and sky. Om, the Pranamanada, the first sound of the cosmos. The stanza begins with Om. Om Bhur Bhuvah Swaha Tat Sarvitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yonah Prachodayat. Bhur Bhuvah Swaha Bhargo, let all the sins of the mind, all the patterns of the mind, all the contamination of the mind in the form of ignorance gets nullified by awakening the sun within, the Prachodayat means divine awakening. So the Gayatri Mantra chanting, understanding makes the awakening of sun inside. At the time of Upanayana, in many traditions, the thread was three threads. And the knot of the thread lies in the Hara area. And with every inhalation, the knot rises with the rise of abdomen. And with every exhalation, the knot goes within, because the abdomen goes within. The rise and fall of this knot, which is placed exactly in the Hara area, is an indication of chanting of Gayatri Mantra from that place, Hara. Because the meaning of Gayatri is Hara. It prepares it, Upanayana. It is meant for Upanayana. It prepares you for meditation by way of becoming a master of Dharana. You become master of meditation. Thank you very much.